welcome. Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. I stand on the existing protocol. And when I come to functions like this, I always start by issuing a disclaimer. Because I am a journalist, and I know what we do in the industry. I say that because I know that whatever I say now, tomorrow, you know, the headline will be, you know, will stop a meeting like here. Now when you read the video, you find like one consequential essay that I'm going to speak somewhere. And then it says that. Yeah, so I like to say that you know, I'm convinced you want to do whatever I say, even when I'm saying nonsense. Well, my remark will be in the form of a story. You know, I practiced journalism and then I came into government. I think sometime shortly I've got into office in 2007. I come from Oyo State. One of my friends became chairman of my village local government. You know, we from Ibadan. We have two local governments. The city, you have a local government in the city. And then those of us who are villages outside the city, you have another local government. So he became chairman of the village local government. How did it happen? The governor was next. I think of Mombadi also was exiting. For almost 4 years, he didn't conduct any local government election. Then when he was leaving office, he now conducted local government election about 2 weeks or so, you know, from his exit date. Of course, we all know what happens at local government election. Votes are not cast, results are declared. So my friend became chairman of my village local government. You know, and he called me. I told me what I was. I said, okay, no problem. He was shocked that I did not congratulate him. So when he came congratulating, I said, yeah, I have looked at it. This is your process. 2 weeks, you conducted an election, and you have become government chairman. He said, well, that is your thing. You forgot that you are not in government. I said, okay, no problem. He didn't go back to me a few weeks after that. Don't forget, I said, you conducted this election 2 weeks. You know, to the next day. So the big governor came in, and of course, the first thing he did was to dissolve the government. So my friend now called me and I said, incidentally, they were from the same party. I said, how could this man have done this? I said, well, what did he do? He said, you know, he dissolved the government. That they had a tenure of 3 years under the law and blah, 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 blah. I said, okay. So your tenure has ended. Say yes. But the governor has dissolved the government. He said yes. I said, okay, fine. How did you come in? You know? He said, but that's not an issue. That is the issue. That's precisely the issue. The way you came in was unlawful, you knew it. And now you have been dissolved unlawfully. So, like in many other vices, my position has always been, you know, that we need to take a stand. At all times. It doesn't matter whether you favor us or you do not favor us. When it is wrong, it is wrong. It cannot be wrong when, for instance, the PDP that is acting and Ryan when it is APC that is acting. So I think it's the same thing with this issue of impunity. I think there is nobody here who will deny that that is a fundamental problem in our country. The issue then is what do we do about it? And I think that for me, it is that all of us must agree that impunity is bad for our system, it's very dangerous, and we must all agree to stop it. This was the same position I had, you know, when people complained to me about electoral malpractices. And I said, look, as a journalist, I have observed politicians. Now I work for politicians. Okay? I know that not a single one of them is innocent of this charge. And the solution to the problem is for all of them to agree that we will play by the rules. Everybody reads, everybody knows all these vices. It is only when we do that in the living process that we complain. And so the solution to the problem, therefore, is that all of them will agree that we are going to this contest, we will follow the rules. And I think it's the same thing with impunity. We must all agree that impunity is extremely injurious to our system, and we must accept know, to stop it. It's not only in government that you have the case. You have had instances of even private citizens, you know, acting based on the police. They do bend to the light and they believe they will get away with it. So I said this morning, this identity, that we must all agree that the first step to take is that the penalty must stop. Citizens must not just, you know, pay this thousand to it, but they must also act. I thank you very much for your support.
Thank you very much, Brother Lee. You have not surprised us. I like your narration, and I really do agree that maybe we need to speak out more on all these kinds of